A recon satellite will be launched from the Kimona Islands rocket base to support our mainland operations. The Irusians responded by deploying a large number of their air superiority fighters to prevent the launch. A large-scale air battle is expected. We must win this battle to maintain our air superiority. We've only got one window of opportunity for this launch. Shoot down as many fighters as possible to preserve top cover over the rocket base.
Shots two. Give me one. Shot one down. Hard enemy radar spike.
Locked on. All right, obvious one. Missile hit. Radar lock. 2 minutes to launch.
Radio failure!
Mobius 1, Box 2.
Mobius 1, shot one down.
Seconds to launch. All ISAF aircraft and vehicles flow to safe area. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, start ignition. 3, 2, 1, ignition. Lift off.
Whoa!
Mobius 1, Box 2.
All systems are in the green. It is now immune to enemy action. Thanks to you, the launch was a success.
The rocket launch proceeded smoothly and all systems are go. Preparations for providing our troops with vital tactical data is now complete.
It won't be long now. It won't be long till it begins. The barkeep's daughter confided to me. As a member of the resistance, she eagerly awaited the Allied counterattack on the mainland. What will happen to these people when the Allies come? I asked, to which she frowned. We'll run them out. This is our town. But I knew she didn't mean that from the bottom of her heart. 13 had captured her heart. I knew this from the way she shot jealous glances at his wingmen. As other pilots rotated out of Yellow Squadron, Yellow 4, 13's wingman, always stuck by his side, even on land. The only female pilot in the squadron, she had Yellow 13's absolute trust as his wingman. Yellow 13 seemed oblivious to all this, and instead reviewed the promising enemy pilot's performance from yesterday's skirmish. He's so close. If he manages to stay alive for just a while longer, that pilot could be a worthy opponent. But when there were no such enemies to look forward to, 13's eyes were sad.